Rescue boat, the Aquarius, carrying more than 600 migrants, is stranded in the Mediterranean after being refused entry to Italy's ports.
It's the Catania public prosecutor who's ordered the seizure of the Aquarius. Italy's Deputy Prime Minister Matteo Salvini was very quick to react. He said, "I did well to block NGO ships. I stopped not only the traffic of illegal immigrants, but as it emerges, also that of toxic waste."
It's been 5 months since the final voyage of the rescue ship Aquarius. But 3,000 nautical miles from Italy in Szczecin, Poland, MSF and SOS Mediterranée are launching a new mission. This is the Ocean Viking, a 69-metre vessel refitted for search and rescue in the Mediterranean. Sailing under the Norwegian flag, Ocean Viking will return to the waters between Libya and Italy. But fearing government shutdown, the ship's existence is being kept secret.
There is enormous pressure by certain countries within the European Union to stop us. Their view is, by stopping NGOs from conducting operations at sea and rescue operations, that it will stop the problem. I don't believe this is true.
People are still dying.
Be careful when we're putting her out, not to put too much pressure on the sponsors.
Yeah.
Nick Romanek is the mission coordinator for SOS Mediterranee. A veteran of the Aquarius missions, the former oil rig diver has overseen migrant rescue in the Mediterranean for the past 3 years.
I believe in rescue. I believe that there's a need for rescue in the Central Mediterranean. People deserve to be saved. They don't deserve to die because of choices that were made or forced upon them. Using death as a preventive measure to stop migration is not really acceptable.
And yet, it's an increasingly popular strategy for governments along the Mediterranean. Italy has closed migrant processing facilities, arrested crews from rescue ships.
Le ONG sono un problema e aiutano I trafficanti di esseri umani.
And demanded that any rescued migrants be returned to war-torn Libya. They credit these hardline tactics with reducing migrant numbers. But they have not lowered the death rates at sea.
Traffickers and stuff like that, I mean, they're pushing these boats out regardless of NGO vessels or any vessels being in the area. We've heard of multiple shipwrecks with serious loss of life. I mean, 150 people in one, I think 60 in the other. The likelihood of dying this year is higher than it's ever been.
Defiant and determined to make a difference, the Ocean Viking set sail for Marseille, France, to collect its new crew and reveal its mission to the world. Boarding today is an international coalition of MSF and SOS Mediterranee volunteers. 31 crew from Europe and the United States, including 13 search and rescue personnel, 5 humanitarian workers, a midwife, and 3 medics.
I decided to accept this mission because, according with the MSF philosophy, it's so evident that nobody is taking care of these people that are trying to cross the Mediterranean.
Joining the medical team, Italian Dr. Luca is a man troubled by his nation's anti-immigrant stance.
I see a lot of frustration in general, a lot of fear, a lot of mental closure. This part of the world needs to gain again the heart that we missed a bit.
Okay.
Most people that we have on board will have been detained for long periods of time in Libya.
Dublin-born Yuka leads the humanitarian team. This is her first Mediterranean mission.
It's going to be quite intense. It's just the reality of who we're going to be surrounded by and the men, the women, the children that we're going to be talking to and the things that they've gone through. I don't know how ready I am for it's going to be quite heavy.
After months of planning, the Ocean Viking set sail on its first mission, a 10-day operation in the Libyan search and rescue zone. They will aid migrants in distress and deliver them to a safe port. They will not, however, comply with European policy to return the rescued to Libya.
You can't save a life to take it and put it back into danger. And that's what's happening in Libya. Maybe someday it will happen that Libya becomes peaceful, but for the time being, there needs to be vessels taking people back to a place of safety.
It takes 3 days to reach the Libyan search and rescue zone. It's patrolled by the Libyan Coast Guard, funded by the EU, with orders to intercept migrants and return them to Libya. But the country is a war zone. The UN estimates around 1.3 million people now need humanitarian assistance in Libya alone, forcing many to flee by boat for Europe, risking interception or death.
Talking about the Libyan Coast Guard, you're talking about an organisation that have patrol boats that are not rescue vessels. They don't have medics on board. They don't have tools to be able to deal with a bunch of people in the water. And the fact of the matter is that people don't want to be rescued by them. I've seen people with my own eyes jumping in the water, swimming away from them. You hear of the atrocities that happen within Libya. People prefer to drown than be taken back. It's not the solution.
The UN Council on Human Rights estimates that over 1,000 people have already died in the SAR this year alone. But now, the Ocean Viking has arrived.
The heading's good, keep on this course. Everyone stand by.
We're in the SARs.
Okay, good to be there. MSF.
Quite overwhelming. Just to know that tonight we could already have a boat full of people, I don't think we can ever really be ready emotionally for that.
Can you give me an estimated range?
The adult not clear, I would say far away.
Okay, yeah, roger that, thank you.
It's 10 p.m. and Nick has received a troubling alert.
Got a message from another NGO via our headquarters. It says that there is about 90 people on a boat that left apparently from the Tripoli area 2 days ago. Apparently it's in our area, so we're going to start searching for that boat.
Responding to the light on the horizon, all teams are put on standby.
Hey, that's good. Yeah, put him over here.
Nick attempts to notify the Libyan Coast Guard to coordinate a search operation.
It's not even ringing right now.
Under maritime law, any ship can help conduct a rescue, but they must first inform authorities. Libya isn't answering.
Yes, good evening. This is Ocean Viking.
Nick now seeks instruction from the nearest European Rescue Coordination Centre in Italy.
I have tried to contact Libyan Coast Guard. For some reason, I can't get through to them.
They tell him to contact Libya.
So I've called, sent one email, and VHF. And for whatever reason, they're not answering.
Now, Nick has only one option.
Easy one and two. Green light.
Two rescue teams head to the approximate position of the distressed boat.
Oh!
With no response from the distressed boat, the search area is widened.
Easy one, please, easy two. I don't have a visual yet, so if you have one, please assist.
After an hour,
easy one and two, come back to Ocean Viking, come back to Ocean Viking.
Copy.
The decision is made to abort.
Hold on. Hold
on. It was weird. We thought we had a target, and there was nothing. I don't know what the condition of that boat's going to be if we find it. If we find it.
Early the next morning, there's a breakthrough.
Yeah, roger that. I have visual. Thank you.
We spotted a maritime patrol aircraft from a European naval force. They spotted the boat with about 80 people on board who were preparing for rescue.
After another failed attempt to reach the Libyan Coast Guard,
yeah, green light. Green light.
The crews launch again. This time, they reach their target.
We are a humanitarian organization, okay? We are here to help you. In a few minutes, everybody's going to be on this ship, okay? Okay, go.
The rescue boats follow strict protocol.
Okay, guys, stay calm like this. It's very good, okay?
Any sudden move could mean dozens in the water, and most of them can't swim.
We're gonna start to give you life jackets. I have enough for everybody, okay?
After risking everything on a rubber boat at sea, the first survivors are ready to come aboard. Ocean Viking's first rescue is now complete.
We found 85 people, four children and five women. The information that we have is that they stayed at the sea for several days, so they need to have some rest.
The distressed boat had been drifting unpowered for 3 days. Their food and water had run out. With the Libyan Coast Guard's failure to arrive, had the Viking not been here, it's likely these people would have perished at sea.
That's really sad. What they've been through, and to be that desperate that you would get in a boat, you don't know how to swim, and to bring your kids with you as well. You know, it's really sad.
But now the survivors have food, water, fresh clothes, and the first safe night that many have known for months.
We have what we call the golden hour, but it's a little bit longer than that. After people are rescued, they'll get changed, they'll try and wash off the salt, the water, the fuel, and you can see kind of some kind of hope coming back into people's eyes a little bit. Some happiness for, you know, to be alive. And then the exhaustion will set in and most people will just go to sleep. And you feel really good about this.
Next morning, the crew focuses on caring for the rescued migrants.
Boarded, there is two like that. You can eat it cold or warm.
Yuka spends time with the survivors to find out and record exactly what they've been through.
They all have a very different story, but resulting in the same in Libya. I can't even imagine the horror.
وخشيت السجون اتعذبت عملت سنة ونص ما زال جروح في جسمي وده حتى ظهر كله جروح كنت خرجوني بالنار حتى كله وده حتى في جسمي
إنهم مهاجرين في ليبيا يعني مارين بظرف صعب يعني في اللي يقتل قتلة وسجون وإرهاب واغتصاب ونهب كون الواحد
In the med bay, Luke attends the wounds of the survivors.
We saw so many patients that have been tortured. We could see signs of electrical shock, beating with sticks or with the back of the gun. Tortures dealt by a knife. Included genitalia mutilations, skin lesions by the application of melted plastic, a lot of sadly creative ways to hurt.
That's how bad it is where they're coming from. They would rather risk dying at sea than go on suffering like that.
Over the next few days, the crew meet many more willing to take that risk.
Hello! We are here to help you!
They respond to three more boats in distress in as many days. One bursts and starts to sink just as they arrive.
Don't jump in the water! Stay where you are!
They find each boat by rushing to the position of circling EU surveillance aircraft.
About 90 degrees.
Shockingly, the planes only contact the Ocean Viking for one of the four boats spotted in distress.
We had some indication that something was happening from the aircraft, but no actual real communication saying, like, there is a distress situation at this location or at this position.
And yet, the instructions from the Italian Rescue Coordination Centre are always the same.
Yes, sir. I have tried to contact the Libyan authorities for the last 5 days. They have not responded once or picked up the phone. Who should I call? Who would you recommend me to contact?
But right now, the crew has a more pressing problem. After four rescues in 5 days, the Viking now has 356 rescued aboard, about 150 more than planned for.
They need to be disembarked as soon as possible. Some of them have been at sea now for about a week, so finding a place of safety for them has become the priority.
Representatives from SOS and MSF have been lobbying for a place to disembark. But so far, no country is willing to accept them.
It's quite clear that disembarkation is not nowadays super easy to get. There is a super high possibility that we are stuck at the sea for days and days.
Is this the one that goes to me, Fred, Sam? Okay.
Yeah. Confident that Malta would answer the call, the crew has just received an official reply.
I
been requesting a place of safety for the last couple of days from the Maltese. And the Maltese have come back and said that it's not their responsibility. Negative on the place of safety. We'll be proceeding north, trying to find a place to disembark.
It's now been 7 days since Malta's refusal to disembark the 356 migrants aboard the Ocean Viking.
Et nous demandons à l'autorité européenne vraiment faire grâce et nous vous ouvrir les ports afin qu'on puisse débarquer de ce bateau. Je vous remercie.
The Viking has now moved to a standby position, exactly halfway between Italy and Malta. Despite earlier refusals, MSF and SOS Mediterranée believe Malta will eventually offer assistance, but only if other EU nations agree to take a share of the migrants.
We're in the kind of the marathon phase of our operations. We don't know how long this situation will go on for. Stay strong, stay professional, and be patient.
Yeah.
3 days later, conditions on board are deteriorating rapidly. After planning to spend just 10 days in the SAR, it's now been 13 days since the first rescue. Food and water has been rationed for all on board. And to preserve fuel, the engines have been stopped, leaving the migrants drifting in a new form of uncertain captivity.
They already suffered so much in their origin country. They suffered during their staying in Libya, during their crossing. And so far, their sufferings is still not finished. This is something that affects not only the body, but also the soul, we can say. And this is absolutely visible.
The standoff is taking a toll on the crew as well.
It's the people's stories that I'm seeing in my dreams, you know. I can't, I just dream about what they've been telling me. And one of the 16-year-olds told me that at night he dreams he's still in Libya. And I can't imagine what his dreams are like, because mine are bad. And, I just can't imagine what it's like for them.
The sun rises on the 14th day of the standoff, but today is different.
Yes. Listen. Okay, so I'll say in English, they will say in Arabic and French, okay?
Okay?
It's been a long time, and you've suffered a long time. But we have just received news that we can take you to Malta. We'll be starting the ship and we will disembark today. It's going to happen.
Following EU negotiations, migrants will be taken to Malta, where they'll then be dispersed between eight European nations.
We're very grateful to Malta, to France, Luxembourg, Germany, Ireland, Romania, and Spain, Portugal, for stepping up and leading the way. And try and find a solution.
The Viking will be met by a patrol boat from the armed forces of Malta. The two will coordinate the safe transfer of all 356 souls to the Maltese vessel. Scheduled, the Maltese patrol boat arrives.
Thank you, sir. We'll start with 20 people on board and see how it goes from there.
Roger, then go ahead with the transfers.
Roger that.
One by one, un par un. La ligne rouge là. En face là.
Thank you.
The same boats that brought the survivors to the Viking now take them a step closer to Europe. After fleeing sickening inhumanity and risking one of the deadliest crossings on Earth, 356 survivors finally set foot on what is effectively European soil.
It has been a great, great, great experience. I feel that I participated to something big, to something that made the difference.
This problem's been going on now for years, and NGOs have stepped in to a certain extent in order to fill a gap. But this should be a European effort to find a durable solution. People are still getting out to sea and not being rescued, and people are still dying, so NGOs still have a role to play. I hope one day this won't be the case, but right now our presence in the area is necessary.
If you'd like to watch any of our stories, Dateline episodes are available on SBS On Demand.